Hi, this is Tracy Hdean. I want to thank you for joining me today for our daily energy and guidance reading. And we're using the Sacred Spirit reading cards by Anna Stark. And you can use this as a pick a card, three card reading, or a blended reading of all three cards together. And as I shuffle the deck, I'm asking all light beings, angels, and God, please relay the message I need to share with my viewers for the highest good of all. And card number one. I'll take a card from the center as card number two. And the bottom card will be card number three. Okay, so we start out with number 21, illuminate the shadow. And oh, wow, what a dark and mysterious card. It looks like we have a raven here and some dark figures here. Looks like this might be a lynx, some type of animal here. And it looks like there's other animals in the background. And these eyes are just so piercing, aren't they? And it says, focus on a solution. And the card reads, when we understand our shadow, we can fully appreciate the light. We must have both aspects within our spirit to have a meaningful life. Without darkness, how can one fully appreciate the beauty and simplicity of life in all of its forms? Once we remove fear and personal doubt, it makes room for love, confidence, and motivation, reclaiming your personal power. Our shadow self highlights the need to place ourselves first. When we are stuck within our shadow side, we're unable to see the light of day. We become clouded and foggy with confusion, often forgetting gratitude and compassion through our own selfish moments. Illuminating the shadow is to fully understand our personality and subsequently understand the shadow in others. Enable us to be more considerate of another person's hardships and developing empathy and compassion for other people. Right now, you're encouraged to illuminate the sections of your personality that are working against your situation. Accept that these challenging aspects are part of you, embrace them, love them, and plan how to achieve a form of balance and make this part of your psyche ultimately work for you. Now is the time to focus on a resolution instead of just on a problem or challenge. How did you get there? Acknowledge your current circumstances and focus on how you can achieve a positive outcome. Now is the time to get your personality in line with conscious thought. Apply these balanced characteristics to areas in your life that could utilize these energies, such as leadership, communication, relationship, employment, and self-talk with your spirit. Once you grow your understanding of your unique personality, you begin to realign your life to nurture and support your goals and personal interests. So yeah, we are a blend of both dark and light. And we need to realize that we all have both. And a lot of people do shadow work. A lot of people keep a book of shadows. The more you understand about your personality and the more you get to know yourself, the easier it is going to be when your shadow side takes over and brings you to a low vibration where you're not feeling grateful for things, you're feeling doom and gloom. It's important to blend both the light and dark sides of your personality. And instead of, you know, looking at whatever problem or challenge you're facing right now in ways that, you know, it's not going to work out, or, you know, playing the victim saying, why does this always happen to me? You got to eliminate that way of thinking and think of a solution instead. Be grateful of whatever situation you're going through, even if it is painful, because you know it's going to be for your highest good. And you know that it's something you need to learn on this path. Life is not perfect. Life is not fair. It's never going to be. But if you could look at life in a feeling of being grateful and, you know, content with what you do have and focus on what's going right instead of what's going wrong, it's going to eliminate that shadow side from taking over, because a lot of us fall into that negative mind frame and that negative self-talk. You know, sometimes all it takes is one negative idea in your head that eventually snowballs into a full-blown thought attack. So be aware, you know, of your shadow side. And then the next card, card number two, is Celestial Gatekeeper. Timing is critical. And here we are again, you know, with this crow, and this is card number seven. And the Celestial Gatekeeper says the eagle, oh, this is an eagle. Every time I'm thinking of a crow because I have so many crows outside in my backyard. It says the eagle is considered a sacred animal in many cultures, unafraid of confrontation. The resilience and unshakable confidence and courage that eagles demonstrate ensures that presence is felt. Their commanding and majestic presence soaring high above the land below demands your respect when you reside or walk within it. And yeah, I've had this eagle flying around every once in a while in the morning when I'm doing these videos. And I believe it was last week where it was telling us to, you know, not be so serious, to take a time out, you know, for play, for something fun. And this eagle was just floating around in the air like it didn't have a care in the world. And it was a beautiful sight. Birds are always messengers. And it also says, flying in between the realms of earth and spirit, these majestic animals are celestial gatekeepers transporting spiritual communication between the heavenly gateways. Exactly. I mean, they bring messages. Anytime an animal crosses your path, whether it be a bird or other animal, they have messages to bring us. Eagles have always been closely associated with God or a spiritual higher power. The Aztecs, Sumerians, Romans, Egyptians, and Native Americans all viewed the eagle as a sacred bird that empowered the people below them. Many ancient and modern cultures adopt the eagle as a spiritual icon. The freedom and wisdom these majestic birds represent is inspiring. These predatory birds rely upon their vision and ability to read wind currents to survive in their natural habitats. The sacred relationship between the Mongols and the golden eagle signify the power and respect these beautiful eagles represent are considered more valuable than human relationships, as they depend upon them for their own survival in the Siberian wilderness. Right now, you require a clear focus of what is ahead of you. Your timing is critical. While you may have a sense of urgency, it is important not to rush. Think about the issues and circumstances carefully before you act. Ensure you have planned your forward process. All decision-making needs to be carefully considered before you jump in prematurely. Make sure you have all the facts in front of you. Eagles are deeply connected to the celestial realm, as are you. Be aware of the eagle's subtle message as they are encouraging you to raise and elevate your vibration to build a divine relationship, a celestial pathway with a higher source. Pay attention to denser, lower energy so you can learn how this interaction affects your personal energy. And yeah, this relates to this card so much, you know, with the illuminating the shadow, you know, being aware of your shadow side and maybe your lower vibration energies and how it affects you, and to focus on a solution instead of focusing on the problem. And this one here is the same thing, saying do not rush in. Whatever problem or challenge you're facing right now, be sure that you have all of the facts before you rush into something. And yes, timing, everything is in divine timing and divine order. So what I'm getting from spirit is not to rush things, not to push things, allow things to unfold. And then the last card here is Soul Fragments. And this is card 33, and it says balance will be restored. How wonderful this ties in with these other cards as well. You know, noticing our shadow side and these negative feelings and thoughts popping into our mind. And, you know, then going with the celestial gatekeeper and getting all your facts together and not, you know, being hasty or rushing into things or jumping into things without knowing all that needs to be known. And then this balance will be restored is so important, because when our life is out of balance, it is just so chaotic, exhausting, anxiety producing. So whatever in your life right now is out of balance, that's causing you all of this pain, things are going to return to balance. And, you know, I believe that karma balances everything out. So it's not like you have to really do much of anything for this balance to be restored, except to be responsible for yourself. And, you know, the universe has a way of balancing things out. And it says the life of our soul is infinite, And while aspects of the self are never truly lost, they can separate through times of trauma, grief, separation, loss, or refusing to deal with an issue. The psyche's self-preservation causes this illusionary disconnection as it chooses to distance itself from the situation in question. These fragments are merely in places our consciousness has chosen to forget to spare the emotional turmoil from an intense emotional experience. Recalling these fragments with love, healing, and understanding allows the soul to continue moving forward without the individual feeling stuck in the past or unable to get over an issue or event. Empowering and liberating, retrieval is recommended if you feel you are missing parts of yourself. Although sometimes challenging to find, conscious thought and skillful self-awareness is all that is required to recall a soul fragment back to its host. Seek a professional guide if you feel more comfortable. Currently, you may be feeling incomplete, not like yourself, physically flat with no motivation, lacking joy in your life, or even that you're unable to move forward in life. Right now, your soul needs to reclaim a part of its missing memory. Past trauma that is being held within you is crying out to be healed. Through recollection, you will be able to see the truth and the situation for what it is. Be careful. You're entering a period in which you will be challenged emotionally. Build your resilience and remain objective. Fear-based experiences need to be addressed now. Past life repression could be beneficial to create understanding or phobias. Deep-seated fears or subconscious patterns that have previously controlled areas of your life reclaim your power. So yes, we are allowing these painful situations, whether they're childhood memories, things that happened long ago, or things that just happened, you know, maybe last year, we're allowing these feelings to come to the surface. We're no longer pushing them down. We're no longer shoving them in the back of our mind where we don't want to deal with them, don't want to face them, because whatever you resist will persist. So if you allow these feelings to come to the surface, accept them. And when I say accept them, I don't mean that whatever was done was right or that it's okay. I'm just saying that you need to accept it is what it is, whatever it was that happened, whoever did what to you, you've got to accept that and allow yourself to heal and to move on. Because when we accept these things, we allow ourselves to heal. And these things will no longer control us or have power over us. So, you know, within the past year, a lot of people have been having all kinds of past hurts and pain and relationship issues come to the surface where we're ready to accept them. We're ready to sit with the feeling. We're ready to start healing it. And we're ready to move on, finally releasing and moving on. And again, balance will be restored. So whatever you've been going through, whatever the challenge is, do not worry. You are going to recapture your happiness again, your zest for life. It's not going to stay like this forever. You know, sooner or later, everything too shall pass and things will be more positive. What a beautiful, beautiful reading. If you've enjoyed this reading, please like it by giving it a thumbs up, share it, and above all, subscribe because I will be back with more.